I always tell people that they should start their songs from inspiration. Start your song with what feels right and feels good and interesting and is attracting your emotional attention. Start there. Now, as soon as you start, as soon as you've got, maybe your inspiration has given you a title and a couple of lines, maybe a whole verse or a whole chorus. I see this all the time, and I can always tell when it's the inspired chorus, you know, or the inspired verse. You can always tell because it's so good. Yeah. As soon as you get that, ask yourself what the song is about. What is the core idea to this song? What is my core idea? What is my inspiration giving me? And then use songcraft to extrapolate the rest of the song from that. Because your inspiration may be giving you two or three songs at once. Inspiration is like a dream. You know how in your dream, in the first part of the dream, you're on a bus going somewhere with strangers, and then suddenly you're on stage in your high school and you don't have any clothes on and you don't know the lines to this play you're supposed to be in, and then suddenly you're on the beach walking with somebody you saw last week. That's inspiration. It's non-linear. Think about, okay, what is this trying to tell me? What is this song about? What do I want to talk about? Why did this occur to me? Because it came to you because you want to talk about it. So of course you should write that song. Okay? And so you start writing, you start developing that, sketching it out, and seeing where that goes. Then your inspiration, the light is turned on. Once you start turning the light on with your inspiration, it's going to give you more. And as you get those lines, you can say, does this fit in my song? Or should I save it for later? If it doesn't fit, put it on another piece of paper. I still write on paper a lot. And put it on another piece of paper or another, open up a new text file or something, and put it at the top of the page. And put it where you can see it. That's why I like putting it on paper initially. Put it where you can see it so that it, when you get another line that maybe goes with that one, you know you can put it over there. So we want to honor our inspiration and keep it and use it always. That is your raw material, and you have to have it. That's your clay. That's your paint. You know, that's all the stuff you start with. And bulk it up. Keep lots of it. In fact, I'm going to ask you to do that. Whenever inspiration strikes, when you get an idea for a lyric line, a verse or chorus, or you get a melody idea or an interesting riff on guitar or piano, keep it somewhere you can find it. The next time you're starting a songwriting session, you'll have something to work on. The more ideas you have, the easier it will be to get started. And check out my songwriting courses. They're filled with information, practical exercises, and hit song examples. They'll spark your creativity and get you writing your best songs.